Amen. We can give God a better praise than that. You live. Thank you for what you've done for you. You are standing to the feet and give God some praise. Amen. 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 Eternal God and Father, we thank you now for your grace and for your mercy. And God, we come standing before you naked because we know that we cannot do anything without you. And so God, we know we're unable in our own strength. So God, we ask right now that you would use us as an instrument to speak to your people. Give us the word that you would have us to say. It is in the name of Jesus that we do pray. We give your holy name thanks. And all of the people of God said amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Next week, next Sunday, we will also be celebrating our holiday. We had not anything big, but we'll be celebrating another harvest day. Amen. This morning we'd like to revisit a passage of scripture from a different perspective. Those of you that have your Bible, we would that you would notice with us the book of Psalms, chapter 30 and verse number 5. Book of Psalms, chapter 30 and verse number 5. There you will find these words from the Revised Standard. For his anger is but for a moment. His favor is for a lifetime. Weeping may linger for a night, but joy comes with the morning. Can we say amen?
Amen.
For his anger is but for a moment. His favor is for a lifetime. Weeping may tarry for the night, but joy comes with the morning. This morning I want to talk about a temporary inconvenience. A temporary inconvenience. Brothers and sisters, you may be experiencing life's night, but keep looking for morning joy. Nobody likes difficult times, but difficult times are especially hard to handle. When it seems like you've done everything right, and you suffer anyway. You seek to live a godly life, but you suffer one health problem after another. While you know many who abuse their bodies with a life of corruption, a life of sinfulness, a life of drunkenness, and they never get sick for a day, you do your job to the best of your ability. But your boss blames you for problems that are beyond your control. While the people who don't acknowledge the work and lie about it gets praise for doing good. You invest many precious hours to help someone get their life together and follow the Lord. But they turn against you and tell others all sorts of lies about you behind your back. When you've done what is right, but things seem to be going against you, you wonder somehow if you are in the will of God. Or maybe there's some hidden sin in your life that needs to be confessed. My brothers and sisters, this morning, we are on a journey walking by faith and not by sight. The journey of life, the journey of faith is developing the ability to trust God when you can't track God. Faith means to believe what we don't see. And the rewards of faith are to see one day what we believe. Faith in God sees the invisible, believes the unbelievable, and experiences the impossible. Brothers and sisters, this morning, the presence of God with us in our suffering and our misfortunes, help us to hold on to our faith in spite of our fears. It is that unseen presence that goes before us, making crooked places straight and rough places smooth. We have this assurance: whatever the Lord has promised, my brothers and sisters, He will provide whatever He says. It is a word that you can count on. When God promises something, you can count on what God has said. God is not obligated to make any promises. But once He makes a promise, He keeps it. God has made pledges with people that He would never fail or never forsake them. Those pledges are ours as well. He joins us in our pain. He walks with us through life's journeys. He helps us to get over our obstacles. And He encourages us when we are afraid. That's simply because He has promised us His presence and access to His power. His spoken word and his written word. And they are our promises. In Psalms, he promised to be a very present help in a time of trouble. In Proverbs, he promised to be our guide and our friend. In Matthew, he promised to be with us always, even until the end of the age. In John, he promises to be our comforter. In Philippians, we are promised that he will supply all our needs. In Corinthians, we are promised that his grace is sufficient. In Jude, he promises us that he's able to keep us from falling. In 1 John, he promised that he heals us. As believers, we must trust and fully and faithfully believe and stand on the promises. The Bible says in his anger, it is but for a moment. And aren't you glad this morning that God doesn't stay angry at all? Aren't you glad this morning that God is not like us? That God does not hold blood year after year for all of our lives. But his anger is just but for a moment. His favor is for life. The only reason why we're here this morning is because we are under the favor of God. The writer reminds us that in this life, sometimes we're going to have to weep. Sometimes we're going to have to shed some tears. Life sometimes is painful. Life sometimes is hurtful. But he tells us that weeping may endure for a night. But joy comes in the morning. His anger is but for a moment. His favor is for life. And after calling God's people to praise, King David then gives them more reasons why we should praise. He here rejoices that the anger of God may be real, but it's only momentary. While his favor is lasting even for a lifetime. This is a contrast between the momentary nature of God and anger with his people and the lasting favor that he holds upon us. In the New Testament, we might say that the correction or discipline of God is but for a moment. Aren't you glad that God doesn't keep on beating us? Aren't you glad that God doesn't keep us in time out? Aren't you glad that God doesn't keep us sick? Aren't you glad that his discipline only lasts for a moment? But his grace abides forever. This description of God's slowness to anger and his readiness to save is given by a man who long time was deeply acquainted with God, God as his judge and as his father. If anybody knew God in a close relationship, it was David. Because the Bible says that David was a man after God's own heart. And so David can tell us a few things about God. Weeping may endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning. David said this as a testimony from his own life. There were many tearful nights followed by joyful moments. David had sons that tried to take his life. He had to run from Saul. Saul tried to kill him. So David spent many tearful nights joy in the moment. The book of Lamentations reminds us in Lamentations 3 and 22 and 23, it says, the steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His mercies never come to an end. They are new every moment. Great is your faithfulness. Aren't you glad that God does not give us stale verses? Aren't you glad that he doesn't give us leftover verses? Aren't you glad that he doesn't put it in the microwave and warm it over? But all of his verses are new every moment. Weeping may endure for a night. Weeping will come to your house and spend the night. Even though you didn't invite, even though you didn't open the door, it'll come into your house and it'll spend the night. It is an expression of how weeping may spend the night with you, only to be gone by the morning. By itself, this passes the meaning into each life. My brothers and sisters, a little rain must fall. Well, you got to take the bad with the good. Or cheer up because things will get better. But what David is talking about is God's disfavor versus God's favor. And it's always expressed in the experiences of life. His conviction is that favor always outweighs disfavor. Morning always follows night. And the weeping believer may be confident that as he keeps his focus on God, he will bring your joy back. Weeping may endure for a night. But nights, I stop by and tell you, are not forever. Because a morning always follows night. And as children of God, we have a tomorrow in our faith. Yes, sir, it may be like this today, but tomorrow, you may have the blues today, but tomorrow, yes, sir, you may be down and out today, but you have a tomorrow's faith, tomorrow does mean the next day, but it really means, and that this is a temporary intervene. Yes, ain't all right. Meanwhile, yes, hold on. Yes, you might be going through right now. But meanwhile, hold on. Yes, let me define meanwhile. It means, that while you're in it, it's hard. It's painful, yeah, it's trying, it's dark, it's uncertain, for somebody today, you know exactly what I'm talking about, because you're there, right now, you're in, the meanwhile, it's hard, yeah, it's painful, and it's dark, you're meanwhile, you're in the place of testing, yeah, the place of waiting, the place of uncertainty, yeah, you're in the place of not knowing, you're in the valley of testing, the valley of trusting, but God sent me here today, with this word, this is only a temporary inconvenience. So hold on, don't lose hope, don't Tonight is not always, morning is not always the next day. Morning may take months, morning may take years, but joy will come. We and the whole world are experiencing a temporary inconvenience.